हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश ओट एंड क्लासेस, एक्सरसाइज 25। गेट रेडी फॉर द डिक्टेशन। डिक्टेशन विल बी स्टार्ट इन 5 सेकेंड। ऑन अदर वर्ड्स, इफ द आर्ग्यूमेंट ऑफ द अपीलेंट देयर इन वॉज एक्सेप्टेड, इट कुड हैव रिजल्टेड इन कन्फाइनिंग द transfer of the raw material from the ship by pipeline to the port area, but it could not be taken to a refinery located outside the port area stop. But the provision did contemplate transporting of the material from the ship to the refineries as also to terminals and vice versa stop. It was in this context that the court proceeded to hold that a purposive construction was needed to avoid a situation of absurdity stop. Much termed on the presence of the words in the port area stop. Therefore, keeping in mind the clear object of the notification, which was self-evident, the court added the words or through to the words in the port area stop. This facilitated the transfer of the raw material from the ships to a refinery or a terminal which need not have to be located in the port area stop. We must understand the decision of this court in the aforesaid context stop. The rational and principle appear inapposite to the cases before us stop. We also do bear in mind that in paragraph 8 within bracket 1, construction of pipelines inter alia was permitted stop. It is thereafter that in paragraph 8 within bracket 2 under CR Judd 2 clause 6th contemplated permitting of storage of non-hazardous cargo such as edible oil, fertilizers and food grain in notified ports stop. We may broaden our inquiry into the relevant contents of CR Judd 3, CR Judd 3 of the 2011 notification was divided into area A, which inter alia dealt with areas up to 200 meters from STL on the landward side in the case of seafront stop. The said clause proclaimed further that the said area would be a no development zone stop. We notice that in CR Judd 3, the ND Judd was not to be applicable in such areas within any port limits stop. Thus, the expression within made its appearance in relation to notified port limits again stop. In the permitted activities in the ND Judd under area A, viz. Up to 200 meters as aforesaid, we find clause within bracket E which permitted facilities for receipt and storage of petroleum products and liquefied petroleum gas as specified in Annexure 2 stop. Area B of CR Judd 3 is described as the area comprised from 200 meters to 500 meters stop. Under the same, we notice that again facilities for receipt and storage of petroleum products and liquefied natural gas as specified in Annexure 2 was permitted stop. We may bear in mind that the very same activity had also been contemplated in area A of CRZ 3 with the area comprised to 200 meters of the high tide line of the landward area in the case of the sea front inter alia stop. Interestingly, when it comes to storage of non-hazardous cargo such as edible oils, fertilizers and food grain in the notified ports, it was permitted activity in area B of CRZ 3 under clause 4 thereof, that is an area located between 200 meters to 500 meters stop. It must be noticed that CRZ 3 had been classified in paragraph 7 essentially as relatively undisturbed area which did not belong to either CRZ 1 or 2, which included the coastal zone in rural areas, both developed and undeveloped, and also areas within municipal limits or in other legally designated urban areas which were not substantially built up stop. We have already noticed the classification of CRZ 2 earlier as areas which had been developed up to or close to the shore line stop. Can it then be said that storage of non-hazardous cargo such as edible oil, fertilizers, food grain permitted in the notified ports in CRZ 3 area B be also permitted in CRZ 3 area A stop? Going by the contents of CRZ 3 under activities which were permitted in the NDZ, we are unable to find any clause which permitted such storage of non-hazardous cargo, including edible oil, inter alia stop. Therefore, in the NDZ area falling under area A of CRZ 3, it may have been impermissible stop. We have made this discussion only to remind ourselves that in interpretation of the notification, we are concerned with a pursuit of a purposive interpretation or a search for a rationale which the court finds fair may meet with limitations which flow from the object of the maker of the notification being confined to the plain meaning of the words used stop. No doubt a situation found in the facts of the case reported in may call for a different approach stop. Reverting back to the controversy projected from the difference between the words within and in, we may notice the following discussion of the NGT, which is a specialized body consisting of a judicial member and a technical member in a statutory appeal under the Act in compact Oxford English Dictionary stop.